In other words, he's running the show. It's hard for me to believe that in any business, you let personal feelings get involved. Because normally, if you're a business person and you let personal feelings get involved, you don't stay in business very long. Now, I understand that you're all upset about the Lakers and how they tried to commandeer Anthony.
Not the Lakers. Not the Lakers. Be clear about it.
I'm being crystal.
Okay. Crystal means clutch, right?
The Lakers tried to commandeer Anthony Davis
from
the Pelicans.
Yeah, it wasn't the Lakers. It was unclutch sports.
Hold on, time, first of all.
It was a LeBron production.
That was not a LeBron production.
He produces everything in Hollywood, including that trade.
LeBron is a player on the Lakers. He's a client of Rich Paul, who's the CEO of Clutch Sports.
Okay, so Rich Paul's the bad guy. Right?
Whatever. Okay. Now, you got to make somebody the villain. But anyway, look, the Pelicans are going to have to make a deal here sooner rather than later. Because the longer you go, Skip, there's a risk that Anthony Davis get hurt. You go to the trade deadline, so the longer this thing plays out, the less value Anthony Davis is going to have for you. Mm. So the best thing you can do is just go ahead and move him along to the best package, the best offer. Mm. And you know who's going to be able to put that together. Because last I checked, when the last time you heard somebody mention Jason Tatum? Man, I heard somebody mention Tatum O'Neal. And I ain't heard her name mentioned in like 5-6 years. Mm. Jason Tatum. Remember Skip on last year? Ooh, he's the best player. He's going to be an all-star next year. Huh? Mm. Really? Is he better than Kuzma? Really? Mm. You feel better? He's better than B.I.? Mm. I don't know.
Okay.
And now what you going to do? Who you going to pair him with? Mm. Oh, you going to pair him with Kyrie? Mm. Bye. Mm. So, look at this. When it's all said and done, when all the smoke is cleared, when all the dust is settled and the sky is blue again, here we are right here in La La Land with the best deal that you could have taken. Can you imagine, Skip, Dale Demps would still have a job if he had taken this deal instead of trying to put Magic Johnson and the Lakers on blast by releasing every trade package that he came up with. Mm. That's what you get, Dale. Now, the same guy that got your job, a job that you could have kept had you made this deal, you could have been sitting in the catbird seat. Mm. But now you're at home watching me tell you how ridiculous you were by doing this.
Mm. The same guy who just 2 weeks ago completely gave up on the AD trade. Sat over there with his chin in his hand. He just gave up. He said, it's not going to happen. Nobody's coming to the Lakers.
I feel better now.
Oh, you feel better.
I feel much better.
Oh, Flopadamas at work again.
I feel better.
Yeah. So, you're right about me. Silly me. I thought that Anthony Davis would reconsider after, number one, they hired David Griffin. I have nothing but respect for David Griffin. Mm-hmm. He brings a credibility to that position they have not had there in New Orleans, maybe ever. Mm-hmm. And number two, they obviously hit the lottery. They landed the number one overall against all odds. And number three, I'm going to say it again. If Anthony chooses to force this trade through, he's going to leave $90 million on the table in New Orleans that he could get for re-signing with his home team.
Well, we do a sign and trade.
Okay. Well, maybe, but I don't think that's going to happen either. I think he's going to walk away from $90 million. And I wonder what his agent, Rich Paul, is advising him
on that. We get it back.
Because it's possible that Rich Paul is at cross purposes here. Who's his priority client? Is it AD or LeBron?
No,
LeBron's more important than Anthony, right?
Hold on.
So maybe he sides with LeBron because he's got to keep his better interests.
I'm not going
to
let you do it. In 2018, his number one focus was who, Skip? The summer of 2018 was LeBron James.
Now it's the
summer of 2019.
And his primary focus is LeBron James.
Anthony Davis will always be LeBron James.
No, it is. You know what?
Two things can be true.
Okay, and I even thought that Anthony would have the cachet with David Griffin to say, hey, could we at least think about maybe taking Ja Morant instead of Zion? Because Ja Morant is a pure pass-first point guard who would be the most beautiful, perfect fit with AD and Drew Holiday, who's more two-guard than point guard, right?
No.
So you got that. The world is your New Orleans oyster if you want it.
Right.
But apparently he still doesn't want it, or maybe his agent doesn't want it.
Skip, but you know, even in today's game, when the three ball is so important, most teams, I'd say 28 out of 30 teams, will never pass on a good big for a good little.
Okay, unless you have a great big, and most people think he's great. I don't know that Anthony Davis is great.
He is great.
Which is why I told you from the start, if we're talking about superstar,
super.
If we're talking about franchise carrier, he is overrated. Mm-mm. He is more of a PER king, a statistical monster, than a winning monster.
I think he's third or fourth all time in PER. Okay.
Yeah, but so his record in the regular season so far in this league is 216 and 250. So he's way under 500. In the regular season, his playoff record is 5-8. Why is that? He doesn't have that dominant Jordan-esque personality that can lift a whole franchise to greatness. He's not built that way. He's more of a complimentary star, which is why I get it. Maybe he needs LeBron just like LeBron needs him. Maybe they would be a better fit together than Anthony trying to carry the whole show, even with Zion beside him and Drew Holiday in New Orleans. Maybe it would be a better fit for him in L.A. So I'm going to give you that.
Okay.
And why? On just pure foolish pride, Dell Demps didn't say, I'll take that, because I told you then. We had LeVar on yesterday, LeVar Ball. And what did he argue with you about? And I was with LeVar on this. I didn't say a word about it because LeVar's trying to say, hey, all these kids are better as a package than Anthony Davis would be with LeBron. And I'm with him on that because I love Lonzo and his potential and Kuzma and B.I. and Josh Hart. And remember, Zubats was in that deal. But Big Zoo that you love.
Skip, I would have agreed with you and LeVar if LeBron James wasn't going into year 17.
Okay, fine. But that package, if true, if the reporting was all true, and I believe it was true, that basically Dell Demps could just say, I'll take him. I don't know that you could fit under the salary cap, but they're all on rookie deals.
Right.
So maybe you could fit a bunch
all of them.
Five of them, right? It's so much. The future could be so great for those five. You just take them and start up. We're back. Hey, they'd be right in the thick of the playoffs like that with those kids as they grow up. And again, you could maybe keep Julius Randle and Drew, and now you got Zion, right? Okay, so they should have done that deal, and maybe they'll do a semblance of this deal right now.
Right.
Which leads us back to our moderator right now, Jen, who covers the Pelicans. So gut feeling as a New Orleans native, where does it now feel like in your eyes that Anthony sits in New Orleans? How do people feel about him? How do you feel about him?
I love him. I've covered him since he was 19 years old. Okay. He and his family are practically like family to me. I have been shocked at the behavior the past year that we've seen out of Anthony Davis. Mm-hmm. It has not been him. And it's not just me saying that. His teammates say that too. He's always been such a great community citizen.